So what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. This is Amber J, and I am coming to you guys tonight with another Kingdom Spouse dream. And this time it is for you fellas. So let me just backtrack a little bit. Last Friday, which was December 16th, the Lord woke me up out of my sleep, and he told me, he said, I want you to start talking to the guys. And I was like, okay, great. You know, I was very excited about it because that's something I've always wanted to do. And especially whenever I got into the YouTube, you know, becoming a content creator, you know, I realized when it comes to Kingdom Spouse, this whole niche, this whole community, nobody's really talking to the guys. It's always driven towards the women, and maybe men could pick up a little bit here and there, but definitely not something directly focused at the men and just talking directly to men. And what makes this prophetic dream, because it's two of them, what makes these dreams so profound is because it's actually speaking to the men who's been standing in the gap and believing for their prodigal wife. We don't talk about them, right? We do not talk about them at all. So, you know, just stating before what made this so profound, what made me so excited is when God gave me the green light to do so, because I never want to do anything outside of the counsel of God, right? Unless the Lord builds the house, you labor in vain. So now is the time, and I'm so excited. So let's get straight into these dreams, okay? So look, I had these dreams. They were like days apart from each other. And I had them in December of last year, 2021. And the first dream was this. I was in the bedroom of my prodigal spouse, and I was laying on his bed, and you know, I had my legs crossed and I had my feet behind my back. You know, you just like kick back, you know, just relaxing. I was like that, and I was just giddy, you know, smiling or whatever, laying on his bed. However, he was on the edge of the bed. He was sitting on the edge of the bed, and he just had like his hands in his hands like this, like, you know, and he just had a look on his face like that as well, like just a troubled look. And so I was, you know, I didn't get it at first. That was just the first dream, and the dream was so quick, and you know, it wasn't a very detailed dream. It was just I was laying on his bed, I'm all giddy and happy, and you know, la la land or whatever, and he has this very stern, serious look on his face. And that was the end of the dream, but that's not the whole dream. At the very end of the dream, not even at the end of the dream, just during the dream, I can hear music playing outside of his bedroom door. I don't know if it was in a hallway, I don't know if it was in another room, but I heard music playing. I just didn't know what it was. I could, you know, could tell it was music, but I couldn't make out the tune, I couldn't make out the words or anything like that. And it is very profound. So that was the whole dream, and that was it. So a few nights later, I had the exact same dream. I mean, I'm in his bedroom. I knew it was his bedroom because it wasn't mine, right? And I have my hands thrown behind my back, and you know, well, you know, just kind of like just relaxing, feet crossed, just, you know, giddy laughing. It's the same thing. He's looking like this, you know, just a very, it's not troubled, but just like a look like he's bothered and he wants to say something, but he really can't. Exact same replica of the first dream. But in this dream, this second go around, I heard the music. I heard the music that was playing. It's like I could hear it now. And so I want to play the song that was playing. I don't know why this song was playing, but I want to play it, okay? Because it's significant. It was a very important part of the dream. So give me a second. I'm about to put it on. This was the song.
I
So the song that was playing in the dream that I could not hear at first, in the first dream, but I could hear in the second dream, was Ready for the World, Love You Down. And like I said, I don't know what's the significance behind that, but I definitely wanted to put that in because that was the difference between the first dream and the second dream, right? And that was it. So look, the thing is this. Your girl, who you've been believing for, this whoever this is for, let me pinpoint who this is supposed to locate. You are the guy believing for the girl. She's been prodigal, and you know you feel terrible. You feel ashamed. You feel embarrassed because number one, there's no one talking to you about this particular situation. Number one, you have no outlet to go vent to. You are afraid that someone's gonna call you out of your name. Definitely, maybe question your manhood or things like that. And it's something that you've been bottling in. But at the same time, you don't doubt or question your walk with God. You don't doubt or question, you're hearing from God. You know what God has been telling you to do. But you just kind of been alone in this whole journey. And no one talks to you. No one, you're almost voiceless. It's just like you and God been in this little cave, right? But all along, you've been believing for this girl because you do love this girl. Outside of God telling you that's your wife, you still love her. You still love her. Like, you just like her, you just like, cause she, she's good people. But at the first, when you first met her, in the first occasion, she didn't show any interest to you and you didn't know why, you may have thought she was dissing you. Maybe there was somebody in the background. Maybe she, was not available for you. But whatever it was, you guys could not, hit it off because of her. You were ready. You were good to go. She was not. And you don't even know why. Look, here is the answer. She couldn't hear. She, when I say hear, her senses were not open. They were not, help me, Holy Spirit. She was not aware of everything. She was not aware of her surroundings, right? Now, in the second dream, this was going on right now, she is aware. Her senses have awakened. She is awakened now. She can hear. She can understand. Let me tell you something. Women, we're not as strong as y'all like to think we are, okay? Whenever we get cheated on, whenever we get abused, whenever we get lied to, don't mistake our forgiveness as healing. We can forgive all day. That doesn't mean we're healed. A lot of women who's gone through a lot of tragedies, in their life, they still have to heal, right? We still have to heal. We don't show it, but it's on the inside. So look, the girl is ready, okay? And whoever this is for, this is only a confirmation. God's already been showing you this. God's already been giving you like little tidbits, little clues. Like you may even see the girl. You may even see a glow on her. You may even see her respond differently. You just see her in a different light. And you want to move forward. But because it hurt you so much the last time that you tried to pursue this girl, you want to make sure that this does not happen again. The Lord is telling you it's not going to happen again. She can hear now. Her senses are awakened. She knows better. She got understanding now. So look, if that don't help you, let this help you. So when I was preparing this word, I was praying. And I was like, God, I just really want to get this out to the guys, just be a better servant to them. Because, they've been going without for a while. And in my prayer, God brought this 1996 Disney movie to me. He gave it to me. And the movie is this, Susie Q. If you've never seen Susie Q before, go watch Susie Q. Okay, so look, it is a 1990s Disney movie. You ain't gonna draw that much from it. But here's the little overview of Susie Q. Susie Q was a tomboy girl, right? And the movie is like based in the 50s or the 60s, in the beginning, right? It's based in the 50s or the 60s. And she's on her way to like a dance, like a little gala or whatever, a little dance. And her date picks her up. Now he's gonna pick her up, but at the same time, her grandfather is telling her, she got to do something. She has some paperwork to take care of, and she's like, no, grandpa, later. Okay, cool. And so You know, so she tells her, you know, grandfather, I just want to, you know, go to the dance, right? I'm just giving you like my interpretation. So she tells her grandfather, she just wants to go to the dance. And she's going to take care of whatever he's trying to tell her, she's going to take care of it later. So she and her date, you know, they are on their way to the dance, but on their way there, they get in this accident over a bridge and the car goes over the bridge. Both of them, you know, die or whatever. And, throughout the majority of the movie, she's just this wandering spirit. Catch that. She's this wandering spirit. Your kingdom wife was just a wandering spirit. It wasn't that she was out there in the world. You know, this culture can really paint a picture of what's going on, or what, you know, or what you may think is going on based upon what you see on Instagram and all this stuff, and you hear all these stories. Let me tell you something. The Bible says this: thou shalt not bear false witness. If you don't know, you don't know. And if God is telling you to trust, then you just trust. Whoever this is for, she went out there being a little city girl. She was a wandering spirit. She was lost. She didn't know what to do. She was like stale. Just like Susie Q in the movie. Susie Q went out there doing all of this, you know. She was just a wandering spirit. And so, you know, just going back to the movie, this is like now in the 90s, probably about 40, you know, years later, 30, 40 years later. And the house that she used to live in, you know, this family moves in. And long story short, you know, she, the teenage son can see her. He's like the only one that can see her. And so he was able to help her with that unfinished business that she had to take care of. And then she was able to help him as well. So look, during this time that you have been without communication with your Susie Q, she has been taking care of family business. She has been maturing. In the movie, Susie Q was very immature, you know, and she has some growing up to do, right? But she's ready now, okay? She's ready now. And even in the at the end of the movie, the teenage guy who helped her on her journey, he brings her back to the bridge where, you know, where she lost her life. And her date from the beginning of the movie, the guy in the beginning of the movie, like from the 50s, like, come on now, this is a movie, so just work with me. You just got to go watch it. But, you know, it's like his the ghostly car or whatever comes back up across the bridge. And this time they transition together, her and her date. You know, now they can finish the course. Now they can finish the journey, right? That's because she had family issues she had to resolve, and she resolved them. She matured and, you know, she grew up as well. This is what happened with your kingdom wife. She was not ignoring you. She did not leave you for another man. She had to grow up, okay? And also, she had to take care of some family issues as well. And there's another part that I wanted to emphasize as well. This is a scripture that came to me as I was preparing this message. How can two walk lest they agree? I'm telling you right now, guys, like this between you and that girl is so solidified. It is like, let me give you a little image, right? You've been walking with God, right? And it's like two children, you know, God has you, he's holding you on his left hand and he's holding her on the right hand. Y'all not walking with each other, but God is walking with you guys because there was an agreement that you guys were supposed to be destined with each other, right? So how can two walk? There was an agreement put in place before y'all. This is literally kingdom ordained. So it, you know, you've been walking and growing. She's been walking and growing as well because it has been settled with God, right? So look, you don't have to worry if you shoot your shot this time. Will she let you down, or will it just be a repeat of what happened the last time? No. Go back to the dream that I had. I heard the music now. I heard what was going on. But at first, it was just a blur, just confusing, you know, just like Susie Q, just a wandering spirit, lost, you know. Women, we can get confused. Y'all know we can get confused. You know that. You know good and well a woman can get confused. A woman can be hungry up a storm. And you ask her what she eat, what she want to eat. What she going to say? She going to tell you she don't know. I don't know. Right? She going to be like, I don't know what I want to eat. Right? Because women, we don't know everything, you know? So this is definitely a different situation, but you know, this is for who it is for. Like, if this is for the guy who's been believing for his girl, look, that girl is ready. You better go shoot your shot. You know, you better go and holler at her and let nothing get in the way, because she is so ready. She's so eager to see you and be with you, because now that her senses have opened and she's aware of where she went wrong, God has shown her some things. She wants to make it up to you too. She wants to make it up to you too, you know? So don't think that you're just about to be, you know, at her beck and call. No, she wants to come to the king, like for real. Like, this queen wants to come to the king. She wants to show you that she's sorry too. She wants to show you that she messed up too. Because she knows now, and God has humbled her heart. She's not one of these city girls, and you know that. You know good and well God would not lead you to a person like that. Like, if there was just going to be her end result, even if there was her at that moment. Look, God calls the things that be not as though it were. Hallelujah. Look, so if God was saying that this was your wife, it's because he knew this person in the months, moments, years ahead. Okay. And if he said, this is the woman that is for you, this is going to be your helpmate, it's because that is what she will be. Okay. So look, and the girl is ready. And the girl is so excited to see you. She's so excited to make up for the lost time. She's so excited to show you the king that you are. She's so excited to just give you this royal treatment. But you got to go act like a king and go take your position, you know. Go, you know, take your crown. And there's one more verse of scripture that the Lord wanted me to share with you guys. And it's coming from the book of Genesis. It is actually Genesis chapter 41, verses 32. And this is in regards to Joseph. Joseph at this time in the Bible, you know, he's been thrown into the pit. He's been thrown into prison. And, you know, word is getting out that this, you know, he can interpret dreams. So Pharaoh calls for Joseph to interpret these dreams that no one else can interpret for him. Right. So after Joseph finished interprets those dreams, this is what he says. So here's the thing. Pharaoh had two dreams in two different forms. This is what Joseph had to tell to Pharaoh. He said, God gave the dream to Pharaoh in two forms. That's because the matter has been firmly decided by God. And it's because God will do it soon. Let me repeat this verse. God gave the dream to Pharaoh in two forms. That's because the matter has been firmly decided by God, and it's because God will do it soon. So look, God gave me that dream in two forms because it has been decided with God. Listen, how can two walk lest they agree? There has been an agreement made in heaven. That girl is your wife. Okay. You've been walking with God. She's been walking with God. Just because y'all didn't see each other does not mean there has not been movement on either side. It has been firmly. The Bible says it has been firmly decided by God, and he's about to do it soon. Men, get yourself ready. Get whatever ready looks like to you. You know what you got to do. In this meantime, if you have been messing with a little woo woo woo, you better get rid of her. Whatever the case may be, being, you know, blowing your money, just being irresponsible, you better cut it out. Cut it out. Whatever getting ready looks like, start getting ready, because God is about to do this thing soon. God released me Friday, December 16th, to start talking to men. Because he's getting ready to do it soon. So look, you guys, I love you with the love of Christ. This is, look, man, look, this is like, you know, you're about to get ready in the ring. Like, this is kind of like, you know, would you call it a sparring partner? I don't know. But whatever, you know what I'm talking about. Hype man, whatever, you know, let me be like your hype girl. Okay. Get ready, because that thing you've been waiting for, that thing that you have been preparing for, that happy moment, the moment you want, man, it's so here, okay? Don't let it catch you off guard. Anyway, good night, you guys. I love you with the love of Christ. Good night. Be blessed. Bye-bye.